My first guest receives over 2,000 fan letters a week. He starred in Lost Boys and License to Drive and will soon be in a brand new movie called Dream, A Little Dream. Let's bring him out, Mr. Corey Haim. Your hair, man.
Yeah, it's red. It's very, very red.
Is that a choice, or did you get tied down?
Tied down and beaten.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that for the movie?
Yeah, I just did Dream a Little Dream, this movie with Jason Robards, and we completed reshoots a couple of weeks ago, actually about a month ago, and they did my hair red, and, you know, I've tampered with it, like, a lot, so I'm kind of letting it grow out. It's kind of green copper now.
How did ladies respond to it?
Wow, it's wild hair, man. You know?
Meaning? L.A.
I
wild
want
women.
You.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Hopefully. Yeah, I don't
how,
know.
How many women are turned on by red hair? Does that... Look like you're going to make love to the brother in the second row. You clap, man.
Yo, what's up, bro?
Oh, I looked over and saw you... Yes, indeed. You just had a birthday?
I just had a birthday, December 23rd.
How old were you?
17.
17.
Thank you.
Boy.
Yeah.
What? See, he's 17 years old. When I was 17, I was like standing in front of a house telling him, I didn't mean to drop your paper in the mud. And you are 17 and a talented, successful actor.
Thank you.
Boy. Do you get, now, you said the 23rd, do you get, see, my mother's birthday is the 26th of
yeah,
December.
Yeah, I get gypped, basically.
Yeah.
Because it's like, I'm Jewish, and so, you know, we celebrate Hanukkah, and this year we want to do something different, so we went out and got a Christmas tree. Yeah, kind of put some ornaments on it, and got one present for three, you know, celebrational times of the year, and I kind of got gypped, so.
I would lie about my birthday. I'd be like, you know, January 27th.
Yeah.
Why don't you lie next year, man? You get more stuff.
I hate lying.
You hate lying?
I love presents, so, you know, whatever I get,
yeah,
I
let's
just
talk about
grab.
Lying. You hate, that was interesting you said that. That was the first thing that came out of your mind. You hate lying.
Yeah, I don't, you know, why lie? It's like you lie, it's like, you know, why not just call the Inquirer, you know, lie big time. Yeah. You know, you lie.
Because that's interesting, because I lie all the time. Really, I'm one of those kind of people, you call me, you sleep. No, man, I just got spit on my pillow just as a decoration, you know? My head is flat on the side. I lie all the time. Do you lie to women?
I lie to my mom.
Oh, to your mom.
Yeah. You know, I lie to women, sure.
wait a minute. Okay. You dating anybody right now?
Free man, single.
Really?
Yeah, loving it.
Brother?
Chip.
I'm setting it up for you, man. Let's talk about the new movie. I like License to Drive. I enjoyed that.
Thank you.
I was hoping I wouldn't have to send you a limo, man. You got a license to drive. You should have come on over.
Yeah. Dream a Little Dream. It's this movie that has this old couple, Jason Robards and Piper Laurie.
Okay.
And they own this house. And, you know, they're your average typical couple. And it's me and Corey Feldman and, like, you know, William McNamara, you know, all these kids. And we take a shortcut to school, and unfortunately, it's through their back lawn, you know?
Okay.
And Jason is trying to intersect with the dream state while he's awake so he can live longer with his wife, you know?
Have you all seen the movie?
And Corey Feldman and Jason Robards, you know, they both have dreams, and their dreams intersect, and, you know, a whole bunch of conflicts start, and it's really wild.
You got to be Copernicus to understand. This is deep, man.
It's deep. It goes deep, 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 you know?
Deep.
Yeah.
But if we watch the clip, maybe we'll understand it a little bit better.
Yeah.
Sandy?
What did you do, Ron? A moose? You're Jinger, right? Right. Me, Jinger. You, Bobby. Me look cool. You good. Al, it's okay, though. It's okay. We'll make it a fashion statement. Oh, listen, I've got some things to do. I'll meet you at school. Bobby, isn't there any film left in your camera, dude? Look, you cannot cut any more classes. Bobby, you're already on the boys' VP most wanted list. You gotta go to school. It's a dirty job. Someone's gotta do it, okay?
Take commercial. We'll be right back to Terry a little bit more.
are closing in on the pennant, and Sunday afternoon at 1, they meet the Astros, live, only on KMPH, Fox 26. Giants Baseball is brought to you by Wells Fargo Bank. Giants Baseball is a presentation of 26 KMPH Sports.
Remember when a new car used to cost less than $5,000? I'll bet you thought those days were over. Well, they're back at Rodway Hyundai Jeep Eagle. This is where you can buy a new Hyundai Excel for only $49.89, and that makes sense. And if you've always wanted a Jeep, come get final closeout savings on all 89 models, from Hyundais to Jeeps, with buys from $49.89 and rebates to $2,000 and zero financing. You don't have to turn back the clock for low prices. Come to Rodway Hyundai Jeep Eagle in the Fresno Auto Center.
Sunday afternoon at 4. A marshal goes to the next town to bring back some fugitives.
I'm going to take these men back with me or kill them where they stand. They got a noon tomorrow.
But the entire town turns against him.
All you need is one man with enough stomach to die first. I'm not leaving till what I came for is done.
Burt Lancaster stars in Lawman, Sunday at 4 on your station. KMPH, Fox 26.
Sunday on America's Most Wanted, Noel Calice. He liked fast cars and smash-and-grab robberies. Police say Calice would make his getaways in stolen cars and then torch them. A prison escapee, Calice was last seen in New York.
Sunday night at 8 on KMPH, Fox 26.
You can bring the world to the people. You can help them, you can give it, you can try. You can fly. Bring a friend to UNICEF card today. You can save the life of a child.
And the world will sing for the life you save. UNICEF, these cards save
Now, looking at the clip, I see the gentleman I always see you hanging out with. What's his name?
Corey Feldman.
Is that your buddy in real life?
Best friend, yeah. Really my best friend. It's true what you hear.
Well, I've seen you guys hanging out at 2020.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, we were there. I got hit by a girl there. Just 2 nights ago, I just said hello, and he goes, bam, just popped me.
Was it like Mike Tyson's sister or something?
Yeah. He's so funny.
Hi. Boom. Don't say hi no more. Now, usually I'm used to seeing you star in movies. I was surprised to see you do like second, third lead in a film.
I'm basically playing, you know, Corey Feldman's best friend. Mm-hmm. I like the part, you know, all my friends, you know, it was North Carolina. It's where I'd filmed this other movie, Silver Bullet by Stephen King. And so we were in the exact same location, you know, exactly where I stayed. And it was just like old memories. And, you know, the cast was pretty much all kids.
Yeah.
So it was like so much fun. You know,
it's something you just wanted to do.
Yeah. And it was like the director was like young, Mark Rocco, you know, mm-hmm. Alex Rocco's kid. And he was, you know, it was just like all so much fun, you know, really good cast.
Yeah.
You know.
Speaking of fun.
Oh, wow. No.
My talent coordinators had like a stack of these. I mean, like a dozen of them, and you were on the cover of every one of them. And first of all, I read something interesting about you. Your idol is Stallone?
My idol, reason for it, because I like people who master a certain character.
You scared me, man. I like people who master a certain character. You really scared. I was like, oh, Lord.
Stallone... really, you know, I mean, for Rambo, for what it's worth, you know, he captures the thing. And I just always had this vision, you know, when I was like a lot littler, Rambo, you know, the son he never had, just something like that, you know.
Oh, you like
something,
you know. That'd be cool. You like to do a movie with
him.
Yeah,
he like finds me in a tree or something, you know.
Yeah.
Something like that. Yeah. So I thought it'd be pretty funny.
Oh, a kid, you know, yeah. You're on the cover of all these magazines, and this one was the funniest. The Ladder of Love.
Really?
Corey's Ladder of Love, and it tells things about you I don't think we want to know. But no, but I guess the girls want to know this kind of stuff, like you have a waterbed.
I had a waterbed.
This is an old magazine, man.
I don't
yeah,
know.
Yeah, how do they find this stuff? Do you tell people?
I don't know. What, it's like they climb on my window and they take... I don't know. I don't know.
So
like,
women are talking, man. Because that's the only way they would know if, like, some woman who had been to your house said, he has a water bed.
See, here's a perfect example. See, this ain't true. Right here. Did you know that Corey has a water bed? I mean, you know, just what you just said. I have a water bed, but now it's different. So this is like old stuff.
You got
stuff
like the frame with a new
mattress. Yeah, I got a futon in my water bed, you know?
Yeah.
And what's your favorite book? Lord of the Flies? That was a book report I did in school. You know what I mean?
Okay, so they do lie in these things.
Yeah, they stretch it a little, you know?
Who is she? Layla?
Lala.
Lala?
Yeah, Lala was a girl that I, you know, was going out with for a while, and just kind of separated.
You hesitated, so it's like, was it date from hell, Corey?
You know, if I'm going to be a brother, she's toast, but, you know, basically
I heard
it's what it is. Yeah. That's why I'm at 2020, man.
Yeah, check that out. Now, video games, you're into that?
Oh, yeah, I bought a game called Space Ace. I formed a corporation called Space Ace, and I just figured, you know, why not get the video game in the house?
Corey's Ladder of Love. Right on here.
Oh, wow.
The lucky ladies in Corey's life.
Yeah, my mom, my sister.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Well, see, they make it look like you're with, like, you know, a blonde and yeah, that, I guess that she looks like you. Excuse us for a minute.
Yeah, I mean, why not, you know? They don't lie to you and they cook you food.
What is this?
No, that's Lala. That's my sister.
That's your sister?
Yeah.
Oh, and that's the girl, Lala.
Yeah.
Oh, you want me to play the camera more? I'm busy. Could y'all wait for a minute, please?
So, now who is this?
Yes. Oh, this is nice. Can we show that? So this, women can take this and put it on their walls.
Yeah, put it right over their bed, wake up every morning too. That's funny.
See, this is cool. I wish they had something like this of me in a magazine, but it's always like me with Cher or me with Esther Rolls, and you have to cut them off, you know?
It's in your hall book, man. That's funny.
Oh, here's a cool one.
That's an old, old picture. Oh, God. Well, I was in a room, and I just, like, was in my trend where all I wore was tank tops and headbands, and, you know, it's just an old thing.
What's next for you?
Well, what was next for me was this flick called Watchers, and they watched it, and it left. Basically, you know, to put it bluntly, he was out for I think it was 4 days. You know, not a bad movie. The director was John Hess. He was a new director, but he was really cool. You know, he was really focused and really like into the ninja karate thing. You know, the whole tai chi thing.
Did you fight in this movie? Watchers?
No, but it's about three lab experiments, and it's about me having like a boot knife and a rifle and going up to a cabin, secluding myself with this lab experiment who is a dog, and then there's two monsters after the dog and. To me, fighting the world, it's like a mini Rambo, except it's not as good, basically.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's it, you know.
It's a pleasure, man. Nice you're a gentleman, you. And I love your work.
Thank
really
you.
Do.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, thanks for being here.
Thanks,
Corey
guys.
Haynes. We'll be back with Rambo.
If you would like to see the Arsenio Hall show in person, write Arsenio Hall tickets, 5555 Melrose Avenue, Hollywood, California, 90038. Thank you.